say so. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so.
Amen.
That has a great significant purpose for our lives as an individual in Christ, because God doesn't want us to remain silent when it comes to worshiping Him. I spoke about worship a little bit this morning because in our relationship with God, we have something. Psalms 107, verses 2 and 3. The scripture says, "Let the redeemed of the Lord say so, whom He hath redeemed from the hand of the enemy, and gathered them out of the lands, from the east and from the west and from the north and from the south." We talk about the four corners of the earth, which signifies that God, His love is extended to every person that's ever lived, that has ever had some trials, and I've went through some things, but the devil can't take away my salvation. Because I'm sealed until the day of redemption. I'm in the hands of a living God. And if you have received Jesus Christ in your heart, then you have been sealed unto the day of redemption. Hallelujah. And so we have to know this. And one thing about Holy Spirit, I found Him to be my helper. He is my, you know, the King James Version says the comforter. When the Spirit of truth is come, it's expedient that I go away, because if I go not away, the comforter will not come. But oh, glory to God, I thank God for the helper, for the comforter. Because when He comforts us, when he walks alongside us, as I was talking about earlier, to imagine that Jesus is right here beside you, there's a presence of God that is manifest, that even though physically you may not see Him, you are aware that He's present. It says, "You shall remember that you were a slave in Egypt, and the Lord your God redeemed you." That simply means that He brings us back into a right standing or a right position in Him. Amen. They want that same feeling. They want that feeling of ecstasy. And they want to just come to a place to where, man, I feel good. How many of you know that that's simply a false, temporary state of mind? That is simply a trick of the devil? But God, who is rich in mercy. But God, hallelujah, when He saves us, you can be high every day of your life, hallelujah, and you can walk in the divine favor of God and not have to worry about trying to reach that high again, because that high is constant.
Yes.
See, that of God. You know how we become an enemy of God? We allow our carnal minds to dictate to us. We can actually be saved and still have a sense of carnality until God shake us. And if you belong to God, He's going to do that. He's going to shake you. Amen. But the thing is,